I wonder if Nuka-Cola hydrates you. I doubt it. It's a cricket outside going nuts, and I don't even care. It's right out there. That is not my car. That better not be my bones there either. No, not my tire, none of the above. Not my rebar. Nope. Back with Ada. Yeah, we just went over here. Okay, so let's. First of all, let's dip inside the cave. Let's get some food. Yummy. Yeah, corn you can eat raw. You know, like in war games. That is a good movie. Sunnyvale, California. Protovision. I have you now. We're alone either. I think I want to eat right after looking at all this brain fungus. Nah. Wake you up in the morning. No. Did not want to drink that gross ass water.
Hey.
Glad to be of service.
Seems to be growing well.
Gotta take care of a bug. Bust some stuff down. Might as well, we're already here.
Maybe I could carry some of that for you.
When I took all, I thought it was just the category, not every single thing out of the workshop. Whoops. Shit. Let's flip some of this garbage with Carla.
Huh?
Carla.
You again. Here to trade?
Let's see what you got.
I got a little bit of everything.
238. I'm assuming we can't do anything with these. Buying straight up garbage. Good deal, Carla. You just got swindled. Gave her a bunch of crap. For the caps. Level. Yeah, this one. Charisma 6? Better crits. We can use that.
I've never lost anyone before. This failure is new to me.
We're already over here. We haven't finished checking this place out. We haven't really checked it out at all. Nuka World, I don't think we can touch. Not yet. We'll get slaughtered. Too many bogeys, like four or five all at once. Maybe five or six, actually, with a fire laser bot thing that destroys us. All right, let's go south. At some point, we need to start doing that charisma. I don't know what the supply lines mean, but it sounds good. As though all the workshops are just connected, liquid, boom, like that. So we don't have to bring anything to and fro. Just craft anywhere, blah blah blah.
Seems to be growing well.
Quite the contraption you've got. Can't say I've seen anything like it.
It's a new line. It's called the Pip-Boy.
Heads up.
What can I do for you?
Heads up.
Hope you find what you're looking for.
Seems to be growing well. Alive.
Let's take a look at what you've got. I've never lost anyone before. This failure is new to me.
Alive.
Looking to lighten your load.
kid, who is that?
Sweet.
What's up, Rocky? And what did I learn from Rocky?
That's it.
First of all, Rocky and Bullwinkle, the OST for NES, is really dumb. But it's that good because it's so dumb. And for enchiladas, if you want to twist it up a little bit, do something perhaps out of left field. Instead of red enchilada sauce or green enchilada sauce, use cream of mushroom. Chicken enchiladas with, you know, jack cheese, something like that. Thank me later. And thanks, Rocky, for that one. Really good.
Seems to be growing well. Hey.
Let's take a look at what you've got. If you find any spare parts, you be sure to let me know. This failure is new to me.
Hey.
Yes. Sir?
Hello. My name is Storytime Simon, and I hope you like stories, because I love to tell stories.
This one
is called The New Squirrel. Come with me on this magical adventure. There once was a young squirrel named Ricky who lived in a big oak tree in a city park. Ricky was a brown squirrel and lived in the oak tree with all his brown squirrel friends and family. Every day, Ricky would look out from the top of his tree and wonder what kind of squirrels lived in other trees. The older squirrels warned Ricky that the squirrels in other trees were thieves and liars. They were never to be trusted. Ricky had a rebellious heart and would not form his opinions based on anecdotal evidence. End of holotape. Please insert holotape 2. Storytime Simon here. Welcome back. And here it is, part 2 of The New Squirrel. One night, a red squirrel appeared at the bottom of Ricky's oak tree and woke Ricky and his family. Oh, please help me, said the red squirrel. I am lost and have nowhere to go. The elders were quick to turn the red squirrel away, but Ricky scurried down the trunk of his tree and stood firm next to the red squirrel. He yelled up at the elder squirrels, how could you turn him away? Just because he's from another tree? He needs our help. Affected by Ricky's assuredness and determination, the elders agreed to take in the red squirrel. The red squirrel thanked Ricky for standing up for him. You won't regret this, he said. End of holotape. Please insert holotape 3.
You won't regret this? That's not the kind of phrase I want to hear. Not at all. You won't regret this. That means you're gonna regret it.
we're basically to the east of the Mayoral Center. I want to bring this power armor back to a settlement. Let's bring it back to Grey Garden right now. I don't want to risk it. Whoops. Hope you like hearing the beep. I know I do. It's gonna take forever. But this is our third power armor. So it's worth it. Ideally, spread out the power armor in every settlement, if that's even a possibility. I don't know. Kind of thing I like to have and never use, because I might have to use it at some point. I still don't know this game for shit. Put this fence here. That's the asshole move of this segment. Whoever put this fence here, why? Why? To go around the fucking fence? Shit. Skyrim has a couple of, you know, strangely placed fences. Like, who the hell? Was that? Like, who the hell would put a fence? I get, you know, it divides property, I suppose, but in Skyrim, you get some weird fences that just make no sense. You know, who built it and who paid for it? And why is it there? It doesn't make any sense. Thank you.
seems to be growing well.
Wait.
I'm afraid I don't do bot stuff.
Thanks a lot. You know what I call a good day? One that ends without an empty stomach.
Hi.
Got work to do. Can't talk now.
May as well take what we can. They won't be needing those items any longer.
Thank you.
Commonwealth justice for you.
Seems to be growing well.
Actually, it's a 5-hour limit. I forgot. I think that's gonna do it for this segment. We got a power armor. Yeah, it'll cap it there at 5. We got a power armor, and we didn't die. I don't think we died all day. Not bad. We'll take it. We still play like shit, and our settlement management is terrible, but we're not dying as much. Yeah. Unless you own a funeral parlor, I think that's a good thing. Thanks for watching.